That is not with us. We have all these things within ourselves. We've got them, they are there, we are the possessors of that. Only thing you assume. Once you start assuming, all badhas will run away, everything will run away, and you'll be surprised. Who can stand a person who is a saint, who is a guru, and who knows he is a guru? Nobody can stand. They'll run away. But you have to have introspection to see that your self-esteem is completely correct. It's not just you are thinking you are a guru. I have known some real gurus, and I would never allow you to go to them. Because God knows if you can come back in one piece or not. And I've told them that they are real gurus, I know, but don't go near them. Because what they lack is this compassion, this sahaj style. Because they think they have worked very hard, so why should these people not work very hard? You may be anything. You can be doing this work, that work. You may be educated, not educated, makes no difference. Whether you are rich, poor, makes no difference at all. As long as you know that you are the Guru and you assume your power. In that assumption, as if any talent, if you know music, you know music. If you know how to cook, you know how to cook. If you are an administrator and if you know administration, you know administration. But that could be also not totally absolute. But you are already in absolute totality of reality. The reality is at your disposal. But you assume it. You are not ordinary at all. We can say you are extraordinary in ordinary. In that, you will just drop out all that is nonsensical. Just drop. Others will see you and will be surprised. What sort of people these are? What sort of a life they lead? How nice they are? How kind they are? And the knowledge is so subtle and so great and of such a highest degree. But you never feel bloated up with ego. I have not seen any Sahaj Yogi who says, oh, I know all about chakras and this and that. How dare you say like that? With the moustaches upward. No. With all this knowledge, you bend down, like the tree which is laden with fruits, bends down. And that humility, that simplicity and that humility gives you the special edge which can pierce into any heart. Thus you become apostles of truth. You can become prophets like William Blake. You can. So many things you will be manifesting and you won't believe yourself. But believe, you are one with that great power which is God Almighty. They were discussing for ages, I think, about the Immaculate Conception of Christ. Such stupid people I have never seen. Why, He is God! He is God Almighty, He is not a human being. He can do anything. How can you judge him and judge his powers and his working? How can you? To discuss about God, have you got his brains? When it's something, a person like me discussing about banking. I after say one or two sentences, I go off. In the same way, when you start discussing God, you must know you do not have that capacity to discuss about God, what his relations are, how he got a son, this and that. Who are you? What's your own position that you can discuss? And then in that humility you realize it's God Almighty. He's Almighty. He can do anything. Then that faith, not blind, but a real faith in that feeling that God is Almighty. And that now you have become the messenger of that. God Almighty gives you all the strength, all the courage, everything.